What God is saying here is that everyone will be set free.
Amen.
No one will be left out.
Amen.
As many that came into today's revival, you will come on free in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
This is the word of God. What next?
And the keeper of the prison awakened out of his sleep.
Yeah.
And seeing the prison doors open.
Yeah.
He drew out his sword.
Uh-huh.
And would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled.
You don't worry. He would have killed himself as a matter of that. Eventually, you go and read it. He also knew God.
Yes.
Amen. You read that passage everywhere. He knew God afterward. That the God that can shake the foundation of the prison. As I'm speaking now, the gathering of the witchcraft is shaking because of
me.
I speak confidently. The gatherings of the witchcraft on the land, in the heavenlies, beneath the ground is shaken because of your success in the name of God. Gatherings of sorcerers is shaken because of you now in the name of God. Gatherings of wizards is shaken because of you in Jesus' name. The camp of satanic angels are shaking now because of your vibration in Jesus. Because you have been set free. John 8:36, I go back to that. It says, if the Son of God shall set you free,
he shall be free.
I'm going to use this passage for our prayer. I'm going to use John chapter 11, verse 38 to 44. That's what we're going to use for a prayer. The first prayer point you're going to pray right now, that Jesus, I thank you because I have been set free. Do you believe you've been set free?
Yes.
If you believe, I want you to stand up, give it to Jesus. Amen. Father, we know that we pray. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Almighty God will bless you for your time like this. I thank you for what you're doing in the life of your people. Despite the fact that everyone is so busy in this country, the first day to the sixth day, the turnout was very good. And this is to show that people are willing. Verses, my people shall be willing in the days of my power. Because people are willing and they came, it is left to you now to demonstrate your power.
Amen.
1 Corinthians 2 verse 1 says, not by speaking the enticing word of man, but by the demonstration of the Spirit of God and His power. In the life of everyone here, including myself, Lord, demonstrate your power in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let us receive instantaneous miracle in Jesus' name. Let there be great testimonies to me.
Yeah.
In Jesus' glorious name, I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You are going to quickly pray to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And the first prayer is that, Lord, I thank you. I just wanted to shake your body.
Amen.
I know the weather is changing, and for that reason, people might be feeling cold. If you are feeling cold, when you get home, put on rub. I'm not a doctor, but I use it to work for me. You know rub, you know what they call rub?
Yes.
I don't know if you have another term for it. It is R-O-B, R-O-B-B. Rub is rub. Amen. Apply it in hot water, boiling one, 100 degrees centigrade. When you apply it in it, just use blanket, cover yourself. Before you know, by the time you sweat, you are you. Yes?
Water.
Eh? What I did
here?
In this weather, if you are cold, you use it. The fact means that you said the weather is hot. Before this weather was hot, some people they thought because the weather is changing, they now left their jacket at home. And they said the weather is hot, isn't it? And for that reason, some people are sneezing now and coughing. And they said they're having a dry throat. It's because of the fact that they've exposed themselves to cold before it was really, really hot. Today is the one we had the real sun, isn't it?
Yes.
We all saw the sun now. Your glory shall shine in Jesus' name.
Yes.
So I'm not saying the weather is good now, don't get me wrong. So you don't say maybe I'm not current. I'm current. At least I see sun. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
You want to open your mouth and pray and say, Lord, I thank you because look at me. I sister Musola is getting it. You know one thing? What I like about boxers, I like something about boxers. You see them, some of them will do like this. Even if they are going to beat him, the actions will be too much. Amen.
Amen.
And you see another one just doing like this. Until they will beat him to the ring. Amen. In your case, you don't have to fight because the person that fights for you never lose.
Yes.
is always a champion.
Oh, yes.
It's been fighting before you are born.
Oh, yes.
He fought before the world was created.
Yes.
And he's been winning. Yes. He fought Satan, and if Satan was chewed down before the creation of Adam and Eve, Satan has been disgraced before that time. So before you are born, God has been fighting. And that's why we call him Mighty Man in Battle.
Yes.
Amen. So I want you to do what? To thank God. Father, I thank you because I've been set free. I thank you that I'm free. I am free. I am free. Okay, I want to pray. Father, I'm free. Father, thank you that I've been set free. I'm free. Jesus set me free. I shall not be bound. Jesus set me free. I shall not be bound. Jesus set me free. I shall not be bound. I shall not be bound. In Jesus' mighty name,
amen.
John 11, we are going to pray serious prayer points with these ones. John chapter 11. John chapter 11. Reading from verse 38. Before you look into that, just say to yourself that in this year,
in this month,
I shall be debt free.
I shall be debt free.
Amen.
Amen.
Whether you know it or not, most people say, I'm not in debt anymore. I'm not in debt. If there's certain things you should have done that you've not done, it's a debt. That's right. In this month,
in this month.
By the power, and let's go to even promote it that in this year. This month is enough. Lord, make me test free this month. Open your mouth. In Jesus' mighty name, pray. Jeremiah 51 verse 58 says, the borders of Babylon shall be utterly broken to pieces. The iron gate shall be burnt by fire. It says, and the enemy shall be with you. Your enemy shall be with you.
Amen.
So the folks shall be thrown in fire as well. Now, concerning Lazarus here, he even said that he's been dead for 4 days and stinking. But what Jesus said when he got there was that he said, Father, I thank you because you've heard me. Not that I thank you because you hear me. I thank you because you've heard me. And the next thing was that he said, remove the stone. You are going to see every hindrances,
every
obstructions to my prayer,
into this program.
By the wind of God,
we
remove the Sahara Desert. Every hindrances to my prayer, by the wind of God, we remove the Sahara Desert. Make it to win the relationship of God. In Jesus Christ, we pray. This is what we are going to quickly do. We are going to hold one people, you tell four people, you are going to pray for four people. You hold this brother, you say, I'm not saying you should go and hold this brother, everybody should go hold this. The number one person, number two, number three, number four. You see what I mean? When I say one, you go to that person. Two, you go to another person. Three, you go to another person. Four, you go to another person. And by the time I say four, if you are not with anybody, it's up to you. All you have to say is that from the prison of hopelessness.
From the prison of hopelessness.
See, there's nothing depressing. When you say depression, there's nothing that's so depressing than when you feel like there's no hope again. When one is going through strain and you feel like there's no more hope, it's so depressing, honestly. From the prison of hopelessness.
From the prison of hopelessness.
I set you free.
I set you free.
In Jesus' name.
You
set that person in my door. I set you free. 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 Jesus said, pray, hear me. I'm not preaching my hopelessness. I said, you preach the gospel. I said, you preach. I said, you preach. Amen. That's just an exercise. You go again. There is a dog. Increase my faith. The reason why some people have not got their miracles is because they are afraid. They're thinking about the problem. They are not looking at the solver of the problem. Peter, the same Peter that walked on the sea, that Jesus called. He said, "Come and walk." And he walked on the sea. He now saw storm. He was not saying, "Hey, this is storm." Look at the person that asked you to come. Don't look at the storm. He that calls you will not forsake you. He cannot call you to make you suffer. Never. He has not brought you this long to make you suffer or to neglect you. That is not the Jesus I know. Oh Lord. Increase my faith. Encourage me, Lord. Jesus Christ, John 11 verse 40 says, then Jesus said, did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? At this time, he has not raised Lazarus. But he's saying it that, did I not tell you? Now, you will see what will happen because I'm telling you that you see the glory of God. Before you sing that song, because you all heard of this story before that, indeed, Lazarus then wake up. After 4 days, he's been stinking there. And this song we are going to sing today is that when I say, Jesus the healer, King of glory. Jesus the healer, King of glory. You know why he said King of glory? The Bible said, lift up your heads, O ye gates. Be thou lifted up everlasting Jesus. And the King of glory shall
come.
So when you call the King of glory, he will just say, okay, I'm interested in your case. You are free. And all you need to do is to what? Clap very well. If you're feeling itch, if you're anything, you can just loosen the bit to make you receive fresh air. You can open the window so that they will feel more ventilation. But the only thing I want is clap very well. So that all those evil masks will disappear. Amen. Are we ready? I'm going to go to the hospital.